Hi everyone, Liam Cambell here, Product and PR Manager at Isuzu UK. And today we're just going to explain the model lineup for Isuzu UK on the all new Isuzu D-Max. So on the left hand side here, we've got the business range, which is made of the utility model. And we've got a single cab, extended cab and double cab. As we progress to the all purpose range, this is made of the DL20 and DL40. DL signifies that a diff lock is now a standard feature in the range, and the 20 and the 40 reflect the model hierarchy. So you've got the 20 and then the system above that is the DL40. And then in the adventure range, at the top there, we've got the all new B-Cross model. So first, what we'll do is we'll start here with the utility model. So like I said, we've got the single extended double cab. For these models, practicality is the order of the day. So on every single model, we've got a rain and light sensor. So automatic headlights, high beam assist, and automatic windscreen wipers are standard on every single model. We've also, at the top of the windscreen, you'll see we've got a stereo camera. So this is unlike a lot of cameras on modern cars. This actually has two lenses, and it works very similar in a very similar way to human eyesight. So a lot of the competitors, they'll have a single camera, and they'll also have a radar in the front bumper to measure the distance. So they're seeing through the eye and then judging the distance by how far it is. This judges distance by comparing the two different views it's getting from the two different cameras and working out how far it is. So like I say, stereo camera, and this enables the forward collision warning, so it can detect other vehicles, cyclists, it can detect pedestrians, and it will warn the driver when it detects that a collision is imminent. If the driver fails to take action, there's also autonomous emergency braking. Again, standard feature on every single model. It also can be road sign, so you've got traffic sign recognition, you've got intelligent speed limiter, just explain about the traffic sign recognition. It will alert the driver to the latest speed limit in the multi-information display. Again, standard on every single model. Then we've also got lane departure warning, so it will detect when you're deviating from your lane, and it will alert the driver with a shake of the steering wheel, and also it will alert them in the multi-information display as well. If the driver fails to take action, the new electronic power steering system, which again is a standard feature throughout the range, will automatically apply steering adjustment to keep that vehicle in the lane, stop it deviating. Again, a great safety feature on every single model. As we progress to the side of the vehicle, so you'll notice that a lot of these customers, a lot of these vehicles will be used in very work environments. Very much like we've got here today, they'll be using a quarry or a construction site or a farm. So you don't want them getting dirty, you don't want them getting stone chipped. So in the high impact areas, so the front and rear bumpers, the door mirrors, door handles, they're all made from a hard wearing black plastic. Again, because you don't want them chipping and getting damaged, they've got that really resistant hard wearing black plastic. You've also got 18 inch steel wheels on the extended and double cab, and then 16 inch steel wheels over there on the single cab as well. The extended and double cab also come with Dunlop AT25 tyres, again as standard. Great practicality from these, and they've got a good balance here between off-road and on-road performance. As we go to the rear of the vehicle, so for the first time ever in the UK, a pickup truck has become available with come standard, rear radar is standard on every single double cab. That is the first time in the UK that's been available. And this powers the blind spot monitor. So you're all familiar with the brand blind spot monitor, the little orange light that illuminates in the door mirror. You've also got rear cross traffic alert. Again, works in a similar way, but when you're reversing out of a bare parking space, it will tell you when something's approaching from either side. Say if you've got like a high-sided panel van either side, you can't see what's going on, this will alert you to oncoming vehicles. You've also got emergency lane keeping as well, which prevents lane changing when there's someone in your blind spot. That's the first time it's been introduced into the UK pickup truck sector. And again, standard on every single double cab. Also standard on every single double cab is the tailgate damper. So again, a lot of our competitors don't offer this at all, or it comes standard midway through the trim level range. We've got it from utility double cab, so it's also on the DL20 extended cab as well. A great, great practical feature. So you've also got, obviously, the maximum practicality with these vehicles. You've got the single cab with a load length of 2,315 millimeters. You've got the extended cab with a load length of 1,805 millimeters. And then you've got the double cab with a load length of 1,495 millimeters. So on the double cab, the wheelbase is actually being extended 30 millimeters. Now, at the same time, 30 millimeters being the magic number on this model, so the overall length of the vehicle is actually reduced by 30 millimeters. And that extra space has been saved at the front of the vehicle, but like I say, extra length has been added to the cab and to the load area as well. So the load area is actually 10 millimeters longer than the previous generation. So again, it's squeezing every last millimeter out of this vehicle. So they're making the cab bigger, they're making the load area bigger, places where you need extra space, but saving space at the front as well and making it more, like I say, the overall length is reduced, making it more manoeuvrable as well.
Just to clarify, when you say the overall length is reduced, you're comparing to the previous model?
Yes,
right, okay.
To the previous model.
Not to the extended one. So this is 30 millimeter longer than the previous car.
Sorry, I should mention as well, the double cab and the extended cab are exactly the same length.
They are exactly the same length.
Exactly the same overall length, so they're both reduced by 30 millimeters, and both the wheelbases are exactly the same, and they've both been extended by 30 millimeters. You've also got lumbar support standard on every single model as well. This is manually adjustable on the single cab, an extended cab, and it's power adjustable on the double cab. You've got height and reach adjustable steering wheel. Again, it's a new steering system, it's electronic power steering, so it's nice and light and maneuverable at low speeds. And then as you go to higher speeds, it stiffens up, it becomes more controllable. You don't want to be accidentally touching the steering wheel at 70 miles an hour, end up three lanes over on the motorway. It becomes really nice and stiff at high speeds. You've got a durable cloth upholstery. Again, a lot of people, practicality is the order of the day on this vehicle. So you want something that's tough and resistant, and you've got that on this vehicle. You've got an easily cleanable vinyl floor covering as well. You don't want to be getting mud stuck in the carpet floor trim, so we've got a vinyl floor covering. You've got a DAB radio standard on every single model. It's got a CD player and two speakers on the utility. And you've also got manual air conditioning standard on every single model as well. So yeah, as I explained, so we've got the all-purpose range, which is made up of the DL20, DL40. As I said, DL stands for diff lock, so diff lock is now a rear diff lock is now standard in the range. And you've got the DL40 and V-cross in the adventure range. So the DL20 is available as an extended cab and a double cab, and then to reflect the lifestyle offering, the DL40 and the V-Cross are just available as double cabs. This is also where automatics become an option in the lineup. So from DL20, you also have the option of a 6-speed automatic transmission with up to 25% quicker gear changes. So it's much smoother now. And this also comes with the additional ADAS functionality of lane keep assist. You've also got adaptive cruise control and automatic pedal misapplication mitigation. So that's when I think you've probably seen those horror stories on YouTube where someone presses a wrong pedal in an automatic. They've stamped down the accelerator when they meant to press the brake, and there's been quite a few viral ones going around recently. That prevents that. That detects if there's a hard stamp on the accelerator when there's something in front, it says that's not right. It detects it and applies the brake instead, preventing that collision.
You didn't mention Porsche Taycan once.
What's that, sorry?
You didn't mention Porsche Taycan once.
No, exactly. Yeah, we've all seen it. So the DL20 has the same headlights as the utility, so it's got the same halogen headlights. You've also got front headlights on the DL20, but as we move up to the DL40 and V-Cross, we've got these really distinctive bi-LED headlights, and they are really they are really smart looking. You've got the LED light here. Like I say, it's different to a lot of other manufacturers. It looks really well on the roads.
Are the LEDs optional on this as well, or that only comes with that?
It only comes with these right. two. Right. Yeah, yeah. Okay. So it's standard fit and standard fit on halogen intercoolers. So it's all about color coding with this these vehicles to distinguish them. Obviously, it's really easy to distinguish the utilities because they've got the black plastics and the steel wheels. But now, in the range, from DL20, you've got 18-inch alloy wheels as standard. A lot of the competitors, they have 18-inch wheels from the top trim level or second top trim level. We've got it on the second trim level. So you've got silver alloy wheels on the DL20. You've got body-coloured front and rear bumpers. You've got body-coloured door mirrors. And you've got silver door handles. Everyone says, aren't these body-coloured door handles? No, they're actually just, by coincidence, they happen to be the same colour as the actual vehicle. As we move up to the DL40, chrome, it's all about chrome on the DL40. So you've got chrome, radiator grille, door mirrors, door handles. You've got silver side steps and two-tone alloy wheels. These really cool, distinctive looking two-tone alloy wheels. And then as we move up to V-Cross, gunmetal is throughout. So it's really consistent colour coding on this model. Got gunmetal radiator grille with insert as well, plus on the bumper there, and alloy wheels, side steps, and door mirrors and door handles. All this really consistent gunmetal styling. As we move to the rear of the vehicle, as you'll see, we've also got integrated side steps into every single model. So it makes it accessing the load area a lot easier and more convenient. You've got rear parking sensors standard from DL20 throughout the rest of the range, but also on the DL40 and V-Cross, you've also got front parking sensors, and if you notice in the tailgate handles, you've also got a reversing camera as well, standard on the two top models. On the DL40 and V-Cross as well, you'll notice you've got these really distinctive and premium looking LED rear lights with chrome surrounds, and again, a bit different to what we've seen before. It's really smart and sets it apart from the crowd. From the DL20, you've also got heated front seats, and that again continues throughout the rest of the range. You've got a more premium cloth upholstery on the DL20, but then as you move up to the DL40, you've got leather seats, and these are 8-way adjustable leather seats, and it matches the leather steering wheel, leather gear stick, and this is and that's also on the V-Cross as well. In terms of infotainment, you've got a 7-inch touchscreen display on the DL40 and a 9-inch touchscreen display on the V-Cross. In terms of speakers, it goes up throughout the range. So you've got 2 speakers on every single utility, 4 on every single DL20, 6 on the DL40, and then 8 speakers on the V-Cross. On the DL40 and V-Cross, you've also got dual zone climate control with rear ventilation panels for increasing the comfort. And you've also got keyless entry and push button start system standard on the DL40 and the V-Cross. So as I explained before, the wheelbase is extended by 30mm, and a lot of this extra space is going to making the rear occupants as comfortable as possible. So the rear seats, the recline now a lot more, so you're not bolt upright, so they're able to relax a bit more, and it making the rear seat occupants a lot more comfortable. So on the double cabs, we've got fold up seats with under seat bare storage, and it's also available at that side as well. It's also standard, at that side as well. And every single, all the seats on the double cabs fold down. So you've got fold down flat rear seats as well. And then the toolkit is nice and conveniently located there behind the rear seats. You've also got the rear USB port and rear ventilation panel on the DL40 and V-Cross as well. DL40 and the V-Cross, we've got three lidded storage compartments conveniently located in the dash. We also have 8 grab handles as standard on the double cabs. Again, making it more convenient to access the vehicle.
Video. If you did, make sure you hit that like button, and you know what, leave a comment and share it if you can, and of course you're subscribing right to youtube.com/browncarguy, of course also to browncarguy.com, and follow me on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and even on TikTok. Just search for my hashtag, it is hashtag browncarguy. And you know what, if you enjoy my content, you can sponsor it as well, and you can do that at patreon.com/browncarguy, and your name will appear like these gentlemen coming up here on my content at the end of the videos, in my written text, and on some of my Instagram posts. And that's a reach of what, 350,000 views in total on my YouTube channel, 2,000 plus subscribers, nearly 8,000 followers on Instagram. So you know what, if you have something to promote, you're most welcome to do that, and you can do that from as little as £2 or $2 a month, the price of buying me a coffee. You do that, right? And you can join this incredible lineup coming up on the screen, which of course includes Muhammad Humaid over in UAE, Partha Srinivasan in India, Tom Conway Gordon here in the UK, Isaac Boshard over in America, Reza Adil here in the UK, also Muhammad Qasim here, Siraj Abbasi here, Mark Waddell in Canada, Zaka Kogliani over in America, and a dear childhood school buddy of mine, Shaheer Hakki, also over in America. See your name coming up here? Just head over to patreon.com/browncarguy, and I'll see you all in the next video.